State game of the week. Here in Fort Worth, Texas, TCU leads West Virginia 17-10 as we get ready for the start of the second half. Anish Raff alongside Dan Hawkins. You look at that first half for TCU at one point, three straight scoring drives. Then the offense went stale and the quarterback, Casey Paul-Hall, took a beating.
Yeah, well, West Virginia started heating them up a little bit, started bringing extra guys. They were getting hits with just four, but the addition of five and six guys later in the second quarter limited the running game, and he got knocked around.
West Virginia will get the ball to start the second half as TCU gets ready to kick off. Both teams 3-5, 1-4 in conference. Both have to go 3-1 the rest of the way in order to become bowl eligible. And Wendell Smallwood tackled shy of the 15-yard line. Time now for today's Taco Bell game track. Casey Paul-Hall, 201 yards, threw a couple of TDs, but as we said, knocked down eight times. And then Charles Sims, 31-yard touchdown run. At over 60 yards rushing on one drive, Clint Trickett throwing a costly interception late in the first half with West Virginia driving.
But in general, Clint Trickett's doing a nice job driving the ball down the field. Other than those two big runs by Sims in the second quarter, not a lot of production consistently running the ball.
Here is Sims in the Houston transfer. Takes it to the 18-yard line, a gain of four, tackled by Chris Hackett.
West Virginia had a chance to get some points there at the end of the second quarter. Fortunately, Clint threw the ball into the free safety, but I thought he got some confidence on that last drive.
Sims again, and he powers his way for a first down, a gain of seven. Charles Sims closing in on his third 100-yard rushing game of the season.
Really a talented player. He can run with some power, has got good speed, good vision, obviously catches the ball well, can do a lot of things really, really well.
Dana Holgorsen said he does more than any running back in the country when you think about his role in this offense. By far the best player on offense that West Virginia has this season. This is Dreamus Smith, native of Wichita, Kansas, until he got the nickname Toto, and Toto lost a couple of yards.
Good little wrinkle. First time we saw that formation this game, trying to run a little outside zone play out of the full house backfield. But again, Gary Patterson's defense just so adept at adjusting to every formation they see in motion. They really attack plays, not just formations.
Trickett going downfield, incomplete. Kevin White, the intended receiver, he was double covered, and one of the guys covering him, number two in black and purple, the All-American corner, Jason Verrett, who's basically taken away White for most of this game.
Yeah, they've had very little success, and it's rightly so, if not even tried out there that much. With that little fly sweep motion, TCU kind of rolling the safety down back into a three-deep coverage. Good adjustment by West Virginia and smart by Clint to throw it over the top, otherwise would have been picked.
On the delay, some room for Sims. Charles Sims with a first down, takes it to the 40-yard line, a gain of 17 yards, brought down by Olabode.
Really nice job on the draw play. And as you mentioned, it was more of a delay draw play. TCU run a little cross stunt with the tackles and got a little bit too wide, and Gary will lecture them on what we call rushing the dots, meaning equal spacing around the quarterback and take away lanes.
Here's Smallwood into the game for Sims. Breaks a tackle across the 45-yard line. There is a penalty marker, an 8-yard play if it stands.
Holding number 76 of the offense. Penalty will be 10 yards from the previous spot. Remains first down.
That's Pat Egger. Right now there's an injured TCU player on the field, and that is Elisha Olabode, the senior free safety. One of the better safeties in the Big 12. Four picks last year, 50 tackles entering today. And he's one of just three senior starters on that TCU defense.
Jeff Hooker back in the game. He got the interception at the end. Looks like he's okay in the second quarter there. Hooker, a former walk-on who earned a scholarship recently.
In the middle of the season, you don't hear that happening too often. Dana Holgerson, I think he got some Red Bull during halftime. He's not subtle, is he?
He was not in the cryo sauna. He wears his heart on his sleeve, trying to get some things going. Obviously, that's a huge, huge penalty. Egger got hurt last week. That kind of hurt him at the center spot. It was good to get him back.
Smallwood broke the initial tackle. Finally brought down after a pickup of four. Hackett in on the stop along with Jonathan Anderson.
Offensively, no one, or I shouldn't say very few, can survive a first and 25. And I think with the offensive woes this year of West Virginia, it's tougher on them for sure.
Trick it over the middle and through the hands of Jordan Thompson. It'll bring up third and long. That one a little too high for Thompson, who's only 5'7".
Well, it's easy to see from up here, but there was a linebacker underneath there, and Clint had to throw a little higher maybe than he wanted, otherwise it would have been intercepted. They've had good success with that play action and throwing it into the soft spot of the seam.
Third and long, West Virginia going to work against the TCU defense that leads the conference in sacks and interceptions. Trick it into coverage. Shorts had it, couldn't hold on. I'm not sure how that got through all the purple.
Wow, threaded the needle. He's got some confidence on that throws, and those throws, he gets it out early. But got to be able to make that. Nice job looking right.
Woo!
Hey, that's one of those, you know, if you do it and it makes it, you're right. If it doesn't, you're wrong.
Nick O'Toole on to punt. Boomstash enjoying his favorite month of the year. Eccles looper hit right as he catches it. Not much of a return. A 48-yard punt. KC Paul Hall and TCU get their first turn on offense in the second half when we return. For TCU quarterback KC Paul Hall, this is his second game back after missing five with a broken left arm. 201 yards passing in that first half. TCU's season high for pass yards in a game this season. Southeast Louisiana, week 2, September 7th. That was the game where Paul Hall got hurt.
Taking about one hit for every 20 yards he gets. They need to eliminate some of those pops in this half.
He finds Trevon Boykin, who filled in at quarterback while Paul Hall was injured. And Boykin picks up a first down, a gain of 12. And that's now five catches for Boykin on the day. He had four on the season coming into today. Boykin stays in the game, lined up in the slot, bottom of your screen. Quarterback to quarterback again as Boykin gets across midfield and into West Virginia territory, a gain of 22.
Casey Pahal showing a lot of confidence and poise there. Got a first down, trying to go fast, hurrying up again.
Boykin out, Tyce Lanina, the speedy freshman in. Here's Doxson, he had a touchdown in the first half. Wrestled out of bounds by Darwin Cook. Doxson marked out at the 41-yard line. It's a pickup of six.
More importantly, TCU doing a good job of eliminating some hits. He's getting the ball out of his hands pretty quickly.
Same play.
Tell you, in modern football, that quick screen, bob screen, wide screen out there has really made tacklers or attempted tacklers out of these corners. They can't just be cover guys. They need to be able to come up and make some plays. West Virginia at times. Now here comes Casey Pahal out of the game. Boykin can get a lineup at quarterback.
Boykin can run. In fact, he has TCU's only 100-yard rushing game of the season. On third and short, Boykin Picks up the first down, moves the chains.
TCU doing a nice job shifting the tight end and the H-back over and got an extra gap. And I think if Boykin would have bounced that just a little farther outside, he'd have creased.
Who does he remind you of? Little Randall L. Cordell, maybe?
I don't know. Those guys.
Not on that level as a passer, but in terms of versatility.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's Aaron Green for a yard.
Cordell Stewart, bigger guy. Randall L., a little smaller. Yeah, maybe.
You know, what's great dimension.
You know what is great to have that kind of mentality on your team, though, that you have guys that are willing to do that. And you start dealing with a bunch of egos about, I play this position and I don't want to share time. And that's what leads to a losing football team.
Paul Hall's pass nearly intercepted by Darwin Cook. He almost had his fifth pick of the year. And Cook knows he should have had it.
He got lucky there, and I think Casey turned his hand over, his right hand over, and was kind of grabbing his thumb there a little bit. I think he hit it on the back of his own player's helmet. Looked like me out there trying to catch that ball. Yeah, he did. Popped it right on the back of the helmet. Boy, I'll tell you, you got to be careful. You end up having a fractured thumb. Of course, they bring Boykin back in.
Ball still in the game. He's split wide as a wide receiver. Empty set for Boykin. Boykin, he gets popped by Kwiatkowski. And it's fourth down. And a decision here for Gary Patterson, given where the ball is. It's at the 34-yard line. It's about a 51-yard attempt. Overchrome does come out for the kick. He's got a big leg. His career-long 53 yards. It's the punter, Ethan Perry, in the game.
Here's the defensive coordinator coming out here where let's punt the ball, play for a little field position. He knows the odds of them scoring a touchdown from 20 or 80 yards away is not going to happen.
West Virginia football, 8:43 to go in the third. They finished the year tied. Kenseth would win the Sprint Cup because he has more wins. West Virginia begins from its own 13. Second possession of the third quarter. Off play action. Trickett in trouble. Sacked by the safety, Sam Carter.
Good call by Gary Patterson. Bringing the safety off the edge. Have not brought a lot of pressure. See right there, crowd the line of scrimmage. Good call. Haven't seen that too much, particularly on first down today for West Virginia.
Patterson praised Carter when we spoke to him yesterday, a kid who came to college as a quarterback. Patterson said he still studies film like a quarterback. Play action. Trickett underneath the shorts. And there's Sam Carter again on the stop after a gain of 12. It brings up third and seven.
Really good recognition by Clint and shorts. A little option route. Got in a single high look, had one-on-one down there, push in, work back outside. Fortunately, when you've got second forever, it's tough. And again, you have to be careful right down here. You're still a seven-point game. Don't put your defense in a bad spot.
Mountaineers 3 of 9 on third down. We'll keep it on the ground, and it's Sims. There is a flag on the play.
Good pressure again. Same blitz they ran on first down. This time it came from the right-hand side. It's in that category of holding, maybe.
Personal foul with hands to the face. Number 47 of the defense. 15-yard penalty would be added to where the play ended. First down.
That's Paul Dawson, who's starting at middle linebacker.
Right in here.
Right there.
Yeah, that's a good call by the officials. Good call. Well, you don't normally see that in there, but good job by the umpire. Get a lot of heat when they don't make them right, but that was a great call.
So West Virginia gets a first down thanks to the penalty. Wendell Smallwood across the 40. Spun down at the 44-yard line. It's a gain of 9 for Smallwood. Second and short.
Coming back to that stretch play out of that full house that they tried to get to. earlier. They had a little more success this time.
Marcus Mallett, one of the linebackers, down for TCU. And as good as TCU is on defense, that linebacker position this year hasn't been what it's been recently. There's no Kenny Kane back there, no Darrell Washington back there. It was one of the question marks heading into the season, and the guys who filled that role, they've been solid, but nothing like TCU has had in the past.
We got a shoulder injury there.
Following our game on ESPNU, Pittsburgh takes on Georgia Tech, 7 Eastern. Georgia Tech looking to make it 3 straight wins. Tom Savage having a pretty good season at quarterback for the Panthers. Dream of Smith tripped up in the backfield. And there's Paul Dawson with a bit of redemption, but another flag at the end of the play.
Really nice recognition. A little different formation there. 2 tight ends, 3 backs in the backfield. Something you don't see a lot of West Virginia, but good job by TCU recognizing. And again, Gary Patterson getting those guys adjusted to the formation and the play.
After the play was over, personal foul, number 42 of the offense. The penalty would be 15 yards from where the play ended. The down did count, so it'll be 3rd down.
That's on Garrett Hope, and that penalty hurts.
Both these teams in general have done a pretty good job this game of avoiding a bunch of penalties, and they're showing up here in the 3rd quarter. See Dana Holgorsen with his game plan on a pretty small piece of paper. Sometimes I think his predecessor is a mentor. Mike Leach has it on a napkin, but
trick it on 3rd down. That's intercepted by Hackett. There is a flag on the play. Hackett takes it into the end zone for a touchdown.
TCU rotated down. Sam Carter rotated.
Holding number 2 of the defense on an eligible receiver. The penalty is 10 yards from the previous spot, and it'll be a 1st down.
A rare mistake by the All-American and Thorpe Award semifinalist Jason Verrett.
Doesn't happen very often, and certainly he's kind of got the skill. He doesn't have to do that, but sometimes that happens. Now you're going to see we're going to rotate down inside. Clint doesn't quite see that.
This is the 1st time out of the 2nd half called by West Virginia.
Timeout by Dana Holgorsen with 6:11 to go in the 3rd, and he's upset with his quarterback, Clint Trickett.
Well, he's probably upset again. Quarterbacks sometimes get it in their mind. I'm going there. They see the snap, or they see the pre-snap look, and you just ignore what your eyes should be looking at. And clearly they rotated down. He should have seen it, and he didn't. Here you're seeing right here, Jason Verrett right there. Boy, I don't know. It's tough. Yeah. And it actually was Chris Hackett, yeah, that rolled down in there.
It's a mulligan for this West Virginia offense. 1st and 10. Ball at the 37. They give it to Sims. He gets 3. 2nd down and 7. You hear some of the words the coaches and players use to kind of describe what's going on offensively at West Virginia after last week's loss to K-State. Clint Trickett said his frustration level is high. Holgorsen has used words like disturbing. Offensive coordinator Shannon Dawson has said a complete non-execution of routine plays. There's no Geno Smith, no Stedman Bailey, no Tavon Austin this year.
Is that the censored versions of the...
The media-friendly versions. Sims tackled by Hooker. And how about the former walk-on who's made a couple of big plays in this game? He had an interception late in the 1st half.
Jeff Hooker just running right downhill, making that play. Now both defenses are crowding the line of scrimmage a little bit. Let's see if Coach Holgorsen doesn't want to line up. This is that big play they had earlier in the 2nd quarter that Sims was so successful at. but TCU rolling the coverage prevented.
Trick it downfield again for White. And Jason Verrett was covering him. And Kevin White, who's become one of the go-to guys in the receiving game for West Virginia the last few games, has had little space against Verrett.
That's what Dana's saying right there. There was the shot. I thought they probably would take a shot. We'll see if TCU takes one on offense, too, because both defenses are starting to crowd the line of scrimmage a little bit more in the second half.
O'Toole punts it away. Here's Eccles Looper inside his own 15, and he gets it to the 15-yard line. TCU led 17-10 at the half. That score still stands. Both West Virginia and TCU need to go 3-1 in November to become bowl eligible. Both have two should-win games on their schedule, one reach game, and that essentially makes this game the swing game.
Definitely big. See Paul Millard over there. He was on the bike just a little while ago, so you wonder if the frustration of Dana Holgerson is going to lead to a quarterback change.
Safety blitz by West Virginia. It's a run play. And a nice pickup there on first down by B.J. Catalan. We check in with Dari.
Guys, time for SportsCenter right now, presented by Cabela's, Kansas and Texas. Jake Heaps hit by Cedric Reed, fumbles. Chris Whaley scoops and scores. Remember, he had the pick six against Oklahoma. Two touchdowns for Whaley, 21-6. Hook 'em horns, guys.
All right, thank you, Dari. Second and 7. TCU coming up on 4 minutes to play here in the third. Pawhall finds David Porter. And Porter with a first down, tackled by the sophomore Carl Joseph. Porter's the only TCU wide receiver this year with a 100-yard game. Did it against Kansas back on October 12th.
West Virginia brought K.J. Dillon off the edge. He elected to take a shot on Casey Pawhall. Maybe could have jumped up and batted the ball.
To the air, Pawhall completes, and that's a gain of 4. It's Boykin again. Good catch for Trevon Boykin. And that's 7 catches now for number 2. Boykin's a guy that'll line up all over the field. He was the quarterback when Pawhall was out with that broken arm, and moving back to wide receiver, playing pretty well today. Aaron Green into the game as running back. Pressure off the edge. Pawhall gets rid of it. Finds Porter again. Joseph there on the stop. And Pawhall down at about the 22-yard line and slow to get up.
Boy, he is one tough kid. They've had success out of that formation. Faking the inside run, but they're bringing pressure, so he pulls it and pays for it.
A.J. Dillon with the hit that time. The reception good enough for a first down.
Impressive outing by Casey Pawhall, not only in his efficiency in throwing, but his toughness.
Low snap. Pawhall under pressure, and he's sacked. Noble Wachichuku.
Good job on the name. Pressure inside. Comes off the right side. Guard was kicking outside. Eric Tosh was kicking outside. Should have stayed inside. Came unblocked.
Wachichuku from Wiley, Texas, which is a little more than an hour from Fort Worth.
A lot of players within an hour of Fort Worth.
Yeah. Again, pressure, little screen pass. Here's Catalan. Chased by Kwiatkowski, tackled by Joseph after a gain of 6. And it's 3rd and long for TCU. And after that promising start early in the game when TCU had 3 straight scoring drives, they've struggled here to move the ball against this West Virginia defense.
Very little running game, and the pressure of West Virginia has really allowed them to get to Casey Pawhall and limit some of those bigger plays.
Pawhall, 269 yards passing. That's a season best in terms of pass yards for TCU. A Again, pressure off the edge from Dillon. It's caught by Brown using the stiff arm and tackled by Travis Bell, shy of the first down marker. So it's fourth down, and here comes Perry to punt it away.
Yeah, good job by West Virginia bringing pressure. Casey had no choice but to go out there, and on first down, that's fine. But when it's third and long, you throw the ball short, and West Virginia did a good job tackling. Just not able to really max up, take a deeper drop, and either throw a double move ball or double cut down the field.
Jordan Thompson waiting for this one. Fair catch signal. Makes it at the 11-yard line, a 46-yard punt.
Casey Paul really showing his toughness, making a couple of touchdown throws, but taking a lot of hits after those touchdowns. And then on nearly every completion, he's getting popped as well, and not a lot of sacks. There's one right there, but certainly a lot of knockdowns. Been impressed with the punters in this game, Anish. Both of them keeping the offenses backed up. And anytime you get back down there on 10-yard line, you got to go 90 yards. That's tough on an offense.
Final 24 seconds of the third quarter. Intercepted. That's Dawson. Tackled inside the 5-yard line, and TCU set up thanks to its defense.
That's the formula for Gary Patterson's ball club. Again, they just do such a nice job of defending plays. They're in quarters coverage. Good job dropping back. Didn't honor the play action pass that time. And Clint Trickett knew it.
Trickett got away with one on West Virginia's last possession when Chris Hackett had an interception that was actually called back because of a penalty. But that time, Paul Dawson makes him pay. Boykin in at quarterback, first and goal for the two. Boykin trying to get to the outside. And he lost a couple of yards, and it looks like he lost the football.
Same power play they ran in short yardage before. West Virginia did a good job adjusting.
West Virginia gets it back.
Rolling on the field is a fumble with a recovery by the defense. First down.
Well, Clint Trickett dodges a bullet. The ball was recovered by Jared Baker in there.
Looked like the ball got out well before
out.
The knee went out when he went down.
Of course, the fumbles have been more backed up for TCU, but again, this is the thing that's been really hurting their ball club this year. And it's one thing to be not be very effective, but when you put the ball on the ground, you turn it over, it's tough on your defense.
Sims right back to the line of scrimmage, and that takes us to the fourth quarter. Nobody scored in that third quarter. Both teams trading turnovers. And the final 25 seconds of that third. We go to the fourth. It's a one-touchdown game in Fort Worth.